Yeah, it's our fifth studio album, basically. First album for the new label AFM, German-based metal label. And we want to take our time with this album, really, because it's a very important record for us to make, because in kind of a funny way, it's our second album again, you know? So we have to make sure we've done this one exactly right, and we were very careful in the making of this. And it seems to be paying dividends at the moment. All the reviews and the press reports have been fantastic, so it's all going in the right direction.
I just wondered if you could like tell us a little bit about, you know, the processes involved in recording the record, and, you know, sort of how you approached getting the new tracks together, writing the new tracks, and then sort of, you know, ultimately recording the tracks as well. Yeah?
We actually did this a very unusual way around. We demoed everything as we were going. It was a very fast process and a very clinical one, because we were using program drums all the way along to play to and work to, and it was very accurate. And we'd record every little bit as we go, so anything that was wrong or anything, we just throw it away straight away. So because we programmed really aggressive beats to the machine to play the guitars on to, we thought, right, let's do this with our drummer, like. So we really pushed the tempos to the max to get as much adrenaline and as much aggression in the guitar tracks as possible. Because generally when a band goes in, they just stick some rough guitar tracks down, nothing special, just played out for the drummer to guide along to. We thought, also that we'd do it full on, proper job, and give him some really pumped up guitars to play to, you know, so he's going to raise his game. If he's hearing these absolutely amazing sounding guitars, he's going to pump him up when he's playing this album. It's absolute razor tight, and it's got to be the playing at the speed, because it would just sound so messy otherwise. There's sick guitar tracks going on in some places playing the same thing, so they've got to be absolutely bloody perfect. We got two aside playing exactly the same thing on each left and right each time, so they've got to be bang on. So all the modern technology now is just a massive assistance to us, because we learned the proper way, so we can still do it that way. This just makes life so much easier, hence the fact that it only took us 17 days to record the whole album.
Right, you've got a cracking cover of Motorhead's Bomber on there, which actually features Motorhead guitarist Phil Campbell and also Tom Angel Ripper from the German thrash metal legend Sodom. So I just wondered if you could just tell us how all that came about.
The history of Onslaught with Motorhead goes back a long way to 1986, actually, when we did a European tour with them on their Orgasmatron tour. We obviously got very friendly with the guys back then. We hadn't done a cover version for many years. I think it was Steve come up with the idea of doing a Motorhead one. They've always been a big influence on us from day one, really. So we thought, why not? It's a great English band, and let's see what we can come up with. Bomber was, I guess, a little kind of off the wall. I mean, this is still a classic Motorhead song, but I think people would have maybe thought Ace of Spades or Overkill or Iron Fist or something like that. But it was a little bit bluesy. It was a real bugger to get the feeling like Onslaught and giving it a thrashy feel, you know? It was sounding really good in rehearsal, but it was still lacking that something. I mean, we still could not make that riff sound right. And Jeff, our bass player, actually works in a music store in Cardiff, and Phil's always popping in and out. So I said, look, just say hello from us and ask him if he's up for coming over and putting some guitar down on this track they were doing. So Jeff asked him, and he jumped at the chance. He said, yeah, I'd love to do it. He said, just tell me when you want me there, and I'll be there. Like, so we got our own little studio over in Swansea where we do a lot of tracking and demoing and stuff. And Phil came down there and gave him a bottle of cider and a bar of chocolate, and he was away. And that was it. It was a good day. And, once he started playing the guitar, playing that riff, everything sort of really fell into place. And you could hear the Motorhead influence, and then you could hear the Onslaught feel, and it just felt really good. So that's how Phil came into things. And with Tom from Sodom, we've been playing a lot of festivals and shows with them since we've been back together. We always sort of appear on a gig with them somewhere. Got quite friendly with the guys, and I knew they were doing their new album at the same time as us. And he loved the idea as well. He said, just send the tracks over to where they were in the studio in Germany. And he done the whole track and said, use what you want. So that's how we came up with that. It's gone really well.
A lot of really dark, fucked up lyrical content in this record. I just wondered if you could tell us a little bit about the concepts behind it all.
all the stuff on the album, all the lyrics are all reality-based stuff I've studied up on, things that are going on in the world you see on TV. There's no fiction going on in there. It's stuff quite deep. If you read into the lyrics, you'll really see what they're on about. So, I mean, we really needed the music and the lyrics to go hand in hand. The music's very aggressive, and we wanted the lyrics and all the imagery around the album to go with it, so just to paint this big picture of violence. You know?
One song title in particular grabbed me from the album. It's called Suicidology. I just wondered if you could tell us a little bit about that.
I've had a couple of friends throughout my life who have actually committed suicide, and it's always a horrible thing to deal with. And you can never quite imagine what was going on in their heads at the time, you know? So I read up on trying to sort of fathom out what goes on in somebody's head. They must be really struggling. There must be voices in there saying, do it, don't do it, and do it, and don't do it. And it's a song about that, basically. The chorus lyrics is the voice in the head trying to encourage this person to do it. You know, it's quite a dark lyric, but that's what it's about, basically.
What advice would you give to any up-and-coming young fans right now?
I think you've got to kind of set yourself above the competition if you can. Spend a lot of time making sure you've got at least 3 or 4 really strong tracks, and make sure you're pretty shit out live, you know. That way, any potential breaks that you're going to be afforded, you're going to look good against the competition, you know. And it's a real tough one. There's so much stuff on the internet out there. I don't know, you just got to bang on doors, I think. We did it that way, and there's nothing to say it won't work these days. So, I mean, obviously there's a lot of other people banging on doors, but you just got to knock that little bit harder, I guess.
Okay, yeah, so thanks so much for coming on the podcast and talking to us.
All right, mate, thanks.
You know, it's been absolutely brilliant having you on.
Pleasure, mate.
Violence! That was The Sounds of Violence, the title track from Onslaught's latest record, which is available now, so go out and buy it because it's bloody marvellous. Right, okay, so we're going to move along a little bit in the timeline now. We're going to kind of go mid-80s to the very early 90s. We're going to look at a band called the Claytown Troupe. I got in touch with the singer Christian Ryu. I'm not sure how you say it. Christian. I don't know. Christian, sorry if I've messed your name up. I'm just a plonker. Right, anyway. So basically, Christian sent me a really nice email, just telling me all this sort of information about the band, and there's some really interesting stuff there. I mean, the Claytown Troupe weren't a heavy band, but they were a hard rock band, and they were actually, they were kind of like in NME and Kerrang, all these sort of magazines. I remember that from back in the day. They were touted as one of the next big things, and they did do incredibly well. They got signed to Island Records. They released a debut album called Through the Veil that Eddie Vedder from Pearl Jam. For those of you that don't know, actually had a conversation, I should say that they supported Pearl Jam at a few shows, and apparently Eddie Vedder went up to Christian and said that Stone Gossard was a massive fan of the Claytown Troupe's Through the Veil record, which must have been gobsmacking. It must have been awesome. What a great compliment there, other things they did, they kind of went on tour with the Cult during their Sonic Temple tour, and I think Matt Sorum played drums for them on that tour, and he obviously went on to go and be in Guns N' Roses for a while, so that's pretty awesome in my book anyway. They supported the Wonder Stuff, the Damn, Julian Cope, Jesus Jones, the Mission, all sorts of people like that. Also another sort of really cool thing that they did was they played over in let me have a look. Yeah, in 1991, they did the Concrete Foundation show in LA, which is a massive heavy metal orientated event. Had bands like Soundgarden, Ozzy Osbourne headlining. This is a band from Bristol. I'm not gonna go on too much. I'm just gonna sort of let the music do the talking. And I hope that people listen to this and sort of think this is really cool. I want to go back and check out these bands. And I know that Claytown Troupe have kind of reformed and done bits and bobs here and there. So check them out. This is the Claytown Troupe, and this is a song off their debut album Through the Veil called Prayer. This fire.